Sorry, I'm back again. The Moroccan Association for Human Rights is under siege. It is under siege. It is being besieged by the Moroccan, you know, themselves. They have accused the Moroccan regime for that the authorities has spied on them. You know, that's a crime. And then we have the Moroccan National Council for Human Rights. And that is something, that is a tool that beautifies the king's policies outside Morocco. So we don't really, it's not legit and it doesn't have any credibility. We don't believe in it. We think it's just bullshit, like what happened with the reef activists or the reef prisoners who's been arrested because of the Herak Rifi. They have been subjected to torture, a lot of violation, but this the Moroccan National Council for Human Rights didn't say anything and didn't really speak about that at all. He even went far beyond that and said, no, there is no torture in Morocco. No torture. Don't bullshit. We don't torture people. We probably do, but we do it like Jose, you know? You know, we put it back somewhere, nobody see, okay, boom, boom. Yeah, you go to, you cannot win. But anyway, sorry for that. But as I say, internally we cannot do a lot because the Moroccan Association for Human Rights is under siege or is being besieged by the Moroccan regime. We have the Moroccan National Council for Human Rights and is not legit and it doesn't have any credibility. That's why we have thought as activists and so as so many people reach up to me as we really want to build a generation that believe in liberal values, believe in freedom of speech. We are, you know, today we got everything is open, you know. We got to know a lot of things in the world because of social media. We got to understand how the world runs. We got to understand what is freedom of speech. We got to understand what is human rights. You know, people have started to understand that. So comparing to with their country, they come to think, no, yeah, we do suffer from this. This is a major issue in Morocco, human rights, freedom of speech. Doesn't exist at all. Doesn't exist. You know. I'm sorry. I don't talk about those who don't want to compare North Africa with the Middle East, Syria, and this. No, we are far. Now we're close to Europe. Please, you know. Let's just be a bit of Europe. You know, a little version of it, at least. So Moroccan youth, they have been really open to the other societies. They have started to learn about the world of freedom, the world of democracy, the world of a freedom of speech, the freedom itself, they have started to learn about. It's just for them, it became some kind of, yeah, it's just as important as water and oxygen, you know, there's no different. If you can, if somebody is going to take your freedom, what is the meaning of your life? There is no meaning. There is no meaning of life if you are being enslaved or being living as those young people who reach up to me on my YouTube and my Facebook channel and on my email. I'm gonna show you some of their letters. They've reached out to me and telling me that they cannot really interact on Facebook because of they live in instant fear. The fear of being arrested. The fear of any time the secret police, they could break into their house. Imagine to live like that, you know? Imagine to live like that. You live and you are just on your room, just like me, like that. So, you know, you're in your room, imagine, and you just, and you know, you just hear sound, somebody break into your door and come on, hello, your name is this and this and this, okay, come back, where at? Jose, you know, Jose is he's the Moroccan king, he wants your ass. Then they take you somewhere, you don't know what kind of aura do you live in, what kind of experience that when you as a student or, you know, as a young person,